My name is McKenna Averly. I graduate in 2016 at Owen J. Roberts High School, and my indoor team is Vipers, and I play forward and midfield. I've been playing since second grade, and I started at like little youth and YMCA clubs, and then like every other sport that I've tried to play, I just always went back to field hockey. So I want to play a college sport because field hockey is like a life for me. I can't imagine not playing field hockey. I've been doing it since I've been little. It's just something that's just been a part of our family. I got to watch my sister play in field hockey, and I hope that I can find a college where like it's a huge family environment.
I've been coaching McKenna for the last two indoor and outdoor seasons. Indoor for U16 and then outdoor for the National Field Hockey Festival and Disney.
McKenna at this point is almost double where she was last year at this time. She's doing very well on varsity, and her confidence is growing, and that's going to articulate into the next 2 years and prepare her for college. McKenna sees the field very well. She makes decisions very quickly, and now it's starting to pull all together, so it looks really good.
I feel like I'm a good teammate because I'm always fit before preseason. I do CrossFit year-round, and I do indoor field hockey and outdoor field hockey, so I'm always sure to be in shape. I feel like I push my team and we both work really well off of each other, and I think I'm encouraging on the field whenever we're down. I'm always sure to like tell them that we are still in it, we just can't give up. When I make a mistake on the field, I respond by not getting frustrated with myself and making sure that I can correct the mistake afterwards and knowing that I can. I'm also sure to remember my mistake but not beat myself up over it during the game.
If McKenna makes a mistake, she immediately turns around. It's not, oh man, she took the ball away from me. It's, I'm getting that ball back. She does have a lot of determination.
I think I'm very positive. Kind of like on field play, whenever we're down, I'm always sure to tell everyone, like, we can still get back. I think I'm very hardworking, and that also has to do with field hockey and schoolwork and friends and balancing that.
McKenna's greatest attributes are her stick skills. She's very poised under pressure. She's very coachable. Anything I ask her to do, she corrects immediately. If she doesn't understand, she'll ask again just to verify that's what I want her to do. She's the first one to pick her team up when we're down, or the first one to give someone a high five or say that's okay if they missed a goal or the ball. If she wants to, you know, be a key part of the corner team, she will stay late and just work on her shot over and over again, asking me for the smallest detail. She's very, very detail oriented and wants to get the technique right.
I really want to become a nurse because like we take care of a mentally challenged man in my house. And my sister's a nurse and I look up to her. She's a really big role model of mine, and seeing how she's been completely successful, she used to play college hockey at Drexel. So just watching her be able to like pursue in her dreams of healthcare and having such a compassionate family, it just really makes me want to go into healthcare. My dad helps with a group home. He's been doing it since he's been like 25. And then my mom met him and she liked what he was doing with Benny. That's his name, Benny. He's been just a part of our family. He's practically like a brother or something to me. He lives with us on weekends and like throughout the weeknights. He's just like a part of our family. Other things I like to do are I'm involved in my chorus class a lot, and I'm really involved in choir, and I really like singing. I've been doing that since elementary school, and I've been in like district choir, and we sing to retired people after school, so that's fun. And I've been playing guitar for 5 years, so I'm just anything musical. Some community service I'm involved in is Leo Club, which is the Lions Club International. I just did a family fun night for Halloween for little kids at East Coventry, my old elementary school. And then I'm also involved in, like, for chorus, we always go to retired homes and we sing to the elderly, which is really nice. I deal with peer pressure by staying true to my own morals and beliefs. I've never really experienced peer pressure that intensely. It's always been what I believe and what my values are, like, comes first. I'll take what other people are saying into consideration, and I understand that, but if it's something like I strongly disagree with, I'm not gonna go with what they're saying just because they're saying it.
I think she'll do very well in college once she transitions to getting to know her teammates and what their successes are. She does very well at making her teammates look good, either feeding them the ball or just being aware of where her teammates are, she'll give reading passes. She reads people very well.
I feel like what I could bring to the college team is that I have really good field awareness and I can make a play happen. I've always been told that I can make really good passes and really nice feather passes across the field, up the field. I can always tell where my other teammate is. I'm always making sure to be like looking around at the other girls and knowing where everyone is in the field because I think that's crucial. It's all about possession. So I'm always looking for that open girl and I will get it there. I know I'm going to be able to manage sports, academics, and my social part of college because it's something I'm already doing now. Meeting new people, that's going to be positive, and I understand it's going to be like tempting to go out socially and do stuff like that, but I know, and I've been doing this since high school, that field hockey and academics are what's going to get you far in life. The social, it's nice to have, but it can't be your whole life in college, and I know I'm going to be able to balance it. In a coach, I'm looking for someone who's willing to work with me. I'm honestly very coachable. Anything that you want me to do, I will be sure to do it. And so if a coach is willing to put the time and effort in me, I'm willing and I want to show them that I can do it.
If McKenna keeps progressing the way she is and her confidence keeps building, her freshman year or her sophomore year in college, she'll be making an impact on whatever team she goes and becomes part of.